Good day and welcome back. So we're going to enter the new chapter about the direct current circuits. So today we're going to talk about internal resistance and Kirchhoff law. So at the end of this video, you should be able to explain what is internal resistance and what is the effects to the circuit. And then we're going to learn about the Kirchhoff law and how we're going to apply it in the circuit. First is about the internal resistance. So something we have learned in SPM. So I will just briefly talk about it. So it is defined as the resistance inside the EMF source, such as the dry cell, due to the chemical itself. So it can cause the voltage drop across the EMF source when the battery is connected in complete circuit. And this will also cause the energy loss through the internal resistance as heat energy. So let's say we have the battery connected to a load. So you just treat the battery as a voltage source E in series with the internal resistance small letter R. So when you connect a voltmeter across the resistance, so we can have expressions of V equal to IR. So from here, we can have the equations of E equal to current multiplied the total resistance R plus R. And then we could have these expressions as the E equal to the voltage across the resistance plus the IR. And from here, we rearrange the equations and we could get the V as negative IR plus E. So here you see that the negative IR is actually refers to the voltage drop across the internal resistance, that when you draw a graph of V against the I, you have a straight line graph that is decreasing linearly. From the equations, you could see that the y-intercept is the EMF source and the gradient would be the negative of internal resistance. So from the graph, when the current is increasing, so we expect more and more voltage drop in the circuit. Next, we're going to talk about Kirchhoff law, where the first law is about the current. It states that the algebra sum of the current flowing into a point equals to the algebra sum of the current flowing out from that point. In simple, the total current entering the point is equal to the total current exiting the point. So we know that the current is defined as the rate of flow of charge. So you can substitute the formula of I equal to Q over T, and you remove the T and you also get expression of the total charge enter the point is equal to the total charge exit the point. And this is consistent with the principle of the conservation of charge. Next is about the second law, which talk about the voltage. So it states that in a closed loop, the algebra sum of the product of the current and resistance, which is referred to the voltage, equals to the algebra sum of the EMF in the loop. So we have the total of the voltage across each of the loads, such as the resistance, is equal to the total EMF in the circuit. So when you multiply both sides with I, so you could get the expression of the power as I squared R or the VI. So we have the total power supplied to the resistance, or sometimes we would say that it is the power dissipated across the resistance is equal to the power supplied by the EMF source. And this is consistent with the principle of the conservation of energy. So after you understand both of this law, now we're going to look at one of the try questions from SMK King George in 2019. So the question given is there is two batteries that having internal resistance which can be neglected, and this is the circuit. So before we proceed to do the questions, I'd like to give you some side note on how we're going to use the Kirchhoff law. So we draw loops in the circuit and we write equations on it. So conventionally, so the EMF will be denoted as positive if the loop is flowing out from its positive terminal. And this follows the conventional current flow, which flowing out from the positive terminal of the battery and ends with the negative terminal of the battery. Next is the current that it will be denoted as positive value if it follows the direction of the loop when you're solving the Kirchhoff law. Let's try to solve the questions. So first, we can apply the Kirchhoff current law. So when you look at this point, so we can have the 0.96 and 0.4 current as entering the point. And we have the current I exit that point. So we have the equations of the I equal to the 0.96 plus 0.4. And you could get the value of the current I as 1.36 ampere. Next, we're going to draw a loop to apply the Kirchhoff voltage law. So whether to draw anti-clockwise or clockwise is depending on you. And this doesn't matter at all, that you only get the answer as negative or positive value. For me, usually I will observe the direction of the current and I will draw a loop that follows the direction of the current. So the value is positive during the process. So from this loop, we can have the E minus 7.2. So you can see that the loop is flowing into the positive terminal of the 7.2 volt battery. So it is denoted as negative value. Next is the voltage across the resistor of 5 ohm and 10 ohm. So since the current follows the direction of the loop, so they are denoted as positive value in this case. So solving these equations will give us the value of the EMF as 25.6 volt. Next, for the second loop, so based on the direction of the current, I will draw an anti-clockwise loop this time. So from the loop, so we can have the equations of 25.6 watt, which obtained from the previous solutions, equal to 1.36 ampere multiplied 10 ohm and 0.4 R. So since the current follows the direction of the loop, so both the current are denoted as positive value. And solving these equations will give us the value of the resistance as 30 ohm. So this is how you apply the Kirchhoff law, where the positive or negative actually depends on two things. First is the direction of the loop that is defined by you yourself. Next, you're going to denote either positive or negative of the EMF and current based on the loop defined. So besides these two loops, actually we could define another loop in this case that we could define a big loop around the circuit. So based on the loop, so we can have the positive 7.2 volts equal to the 0.4 multiplied the 30 ohm. And we have the negative 0.96 ampere since the current is against the direction of the loop multiplied the 5 ohm resistance. And when you solve the right sides of the equations, they are equal to 7.2, and this equation is considered as valid equations. So after solving these questions, I would like to add another thing in this case. What if we don't ignore the internal resistance? So from the previous solutions, we still use the same value for the E and R, except we could not refer back again the value of the current, since the effective resistance now is no longer the same. To solve these questions, what we do is we just add a resistor in series with the battery. So let's say the internal resistance is 1 ohm for both of the battery. So we're going to repeat the same step that we apply the Kirchhoff law. We draw the first loop on the top. And from that loop, we can write down the equations where we have more resistance from the internal resistance of the battery. Simplify the equations, and we're going to do the second loop. And from that loop, we have these equations. So solving these two equations would bring you the value of 0.82 for the first current and 0.4 ampere for the second current. Compared with the previous case, so you can see there's decrease in the current due to the voltage drop across the internal resistance. We can calculate the total voltage drop by applying the formula of V equal to IR, and you will get 1.225 watts. In short, the internal resistance can cause the voltage drop by increasing the effective resistance and reduce the magnitude of the current flow in the circuit. So that's all for my discussion for today. So if you have any questions regarding with the Kirchhoff law, you can leave it in the comment section below. Also do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I see you in my next video. Thank you.